Hello everyone, welcome back to more Let's Glitch Super Mario World. Next up is Donut Ghost House. And I'm actually going to get the secret exit for this level first, because I want the top secret area. So, as you probably know, you just fly up here and go over to the right here. And I'll go ahead and show something off with these blocks here. So as you can see, there's a string of 1-up blocks here. And there's a cloud of booze above me that's diving down at me, and it's probably gonna kill me if I'm not careful with this. But what I'm gonna try to do is hit one of the blocks with my cape from the side, like this, at the same time that I take damage from a boo. It's effectively the same thing that I showed in Donut Plains 1, except instead of screen scrolling, I take damage. Okay, this is a good spot. But it's effectively the same thing. I was a couple frames late. Oh my god, unpause. Early. There we go, perfect. And, so what that did is it caused a bunch of 1-ups to spawn from the same block, and there were so many sprites on screen that you couldn't really tell, but, there were a bunch of 1-ups that came out of that block. They were all just kind of overlapping each other. But, and also the game started slowing down because there were so many sprites. But, I collected all the ones that came out of the block, but you'll notice one of the 1-ups actually didn't spawn normally. It basically got sucked up into the boo cloud. So if you look directly above me, you can see that one of the 1-ups is up there with the boos. And it's actually teleporting around up in the boo cloud as if it were a boo. I'm not really sure what causes this. I guess it's just from having a lot of sprites on screen. But, it's kind of funny that it gets sucked up like that. And it's not just a graphical glitch, either. Its hitbox actually is moving around with it, so you can actually collect it while it's doing that. For whatever reason, I guess it doesn't last forever. I'm not entirely sure if that's because it teleported off-screen and despawned, or if it just has... if it only lasts for a certain amount of time or what, but... it's gone now, but technically I could have collected it while it was doing that, if I was careful and not, and didn't jump into a boo on accident. But yeah, it's kind of silly. I'm not sure why that happens. Well, it's a good thing I got the secret exit here, because the top secret area, I mean, because I need to repower up. I also got the bonus game. Once again, I will be coming back to the bonus game later, but. Not really anything exciting to do here. By the way, I'm terrible at this. Probably because I don't really try that hard. But yeah. Oh well. So that's, the bonus game, again. Oh, another interesting thing about this level. The exit I just got in that level is technically the normal exit for that level. Even though it uses the secret exit path. And the secret exit actually uses the normal exit path. You can't really tell the difference unless you, like, actually, like, look at the game's memory or, like, look in Lunar Magic or something. But, yeah, they're technically, like, reversed like that. And I think that's the only level in the game that's like that, which is kind of odd, but whatever. So this is the top secret area, as you probably know. It's got power-ups and things. Middle block is a Yoshi, but I actually don't want the Yoshi because... Well, I'm gonna go ahead and show off something you can do in the top secret area, which is pretty fun. So what I'm gonna try to do is yet another variant of the hit a block with your cape glitch that I've been showing a lot. But this time, instead of taking damage, I'm going to use the power-up from my item box, and at the same time I collect the power-up, hit the block. So kinda like, not like that, it's really... Or actually late, I guess. I was late. There we go. Perfect. And it's hard to tell, but there's actually 8 Yoshis that came out of that block. You can see because of me mounting them like that. So yeah. 7 of the Yoshis are invisible. Only one Yoshi can be visible at a time. If there's multiple ones in the level. And you can see if I throw this one off the level, the next one in line spawns, and it goes in, whichever one is in the lowest sprite slot will spawn, or will turn visible, I mean. So yeah, So what I'm gonna do with these Yoshis is, I'm actually going to find a way to kill myself in the top secret area. Even though there aren't any damage sources in this level, and there's no pitfalls, as you can see, there's not even a time limit. There is a way to die using glitches, and that's what I'm gonna show. There's actually multiple ways to die. You could bring a damage source into the level using the chuck-eating glitch, but that's kind of out of the spirit of what I'm gonna do here, so... What I'm gonna do is get rid of all but two Yoshis. That should be the first two, I think, or the first three. I lost count already. Whatever. I should be able to tell when I'm getting close. Oh, whoops. That's not what I wanted to do. Yeah, the reason... Okay, so when you're riding... So, okay, I just mounted one of the invisible Yoshis that's on top of this block, right? You can hear the music playing from the Yoshi music in the background. And when I dismount him, I actually dismount him from the same vertical position that I mounted him at, because when you're riding an invisible Yoshi, it doesn't actually follow underneath Mario like a regular Yoshi does. So it's still on top of that block, even though I'm riding it, and it doesn't actually move with me. But if I dismount it by pressing A, like, if I dismount it when I'm in the air like that, then it'll just fall straight down. But if I jump forward and dismount it in the air like that, it'll actually cause him to be flung forward. And so you can see he's no longer on the block, because he actually got flung forward onto the ground here somewhere. I'm not entirely sure where. Okay, there's some here. I'm not sure how these got beneath the block. I guess maybe what happened was they got flung from on top of this block and actually fell... so far that they... Oh my god, get out of here. Maybe they actually got flung so far that they hit the side of this block and then bounced back. That's what I would guess. But you'll notice not all the invisible Yoshis are in the same spot. That's because I mounted them at different times, like on different frames. So they were at different heights when I mounted them, so when I flung them forward, they were in different... they landed in different spots. But anyway, I want to... get rid of all these extra Yoshis. Let's see, get rid of you. So you can see that I'm dismounting the visible Yoshi every time, so that I can dismount all the invisible ones as well. And so I can kind of separate them. There we go. Okay, is that the last two Yoshis? Or actually, I might have killed the second to last one. Okay, now there's one here. So that should be the last two. So now what I'm gonna do is, so there's an invisible Yoshi on the ground right here, and I'm gonna try to fling him forward a few times until he's in the position that I want him to be. So I'm just gonna keep flinging him forward. Oh my god. So he's moving slightly forward across the ground. Ugh. Wow. Yeah, and when you dismount a Yoshi, like I said, you dismount him from the same vertical position that you mounted him. Okay, he's over here now. A little bit further. I think one more. That should be good. Okay, so now he's pretty much right underneath this block. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna get nice and close to the edge so that I can actually, when I press A, Yoshi will actually fall off the side of the level and fall off screen. And then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna mount that other Yoshi that's right underneath that block just before the first Yoshi despawns. And what that will do... Oops, I messed up. Just ignore that. What that will do is cause me to fall through the floor. So let me rewind and show you what happened. Oh my god, pause. Rewind, there we go. So right here, I mounted the Yoshi, and then the first Yoshi despawns, and when the first Yoshi despawns, the second Yoshi that I just mounted, because I'm riding him, he appears underneath me, and... when I'm on the ground and he appears underneath me, he actually pulls me through the floor. So I actually fell through the floor and died. So it's just a really complicated way to kill yourself in the top secret area. And you can see the time up screen pops up, and that's just because the level has 0 seconds. So the game interprets the death as a time up death. Just something kind of silly you can do in the top secret area. Not really much point to it, obviously, but it's fun. Anyway, so that was that. Let's go ahead and power up again. I'll even get Yoshi again. I'm glad I got to show that off at least, because that was fun. Alright, now Donut Ghost House. Let's go ahead and do the normal exit. So, you can actually, I didn't think about this the first time, but you can actually fly under this level. Like through one of those gaps in the floor, you can float, like keep flying underneath, and actually like, theoretically you could get under this wall right here. There's a tiny bit of space between the bottom of the wall and the very bottom of the level where you die. So you could actually get under that wall and keep flying underneath it, but it's pretty hard to do. Basically that would be maybe slightly faster than going up the normal way, like flying over the normal way, because you don't have to turn around. But it would be incredibly harder and probably TAS only. Also, you can just fly up there on this level. Or if you don't have a feather, you can bounce off the booze as well. Although you probably want to get a running jump beforehand so that the camera actually scrolls upward. But yeah, you can actually bounce off the booze to get up to that door, so you don't have to do any of the door puzzle stuff. And that level is actually made up of two rooms. That puzzle is actually made up of two rooms that look similar but are actually completely different, as you probably know. So that first room has the vine block that leads up to the door at the top, and the second room has a P-switch but no door at the top that leads to the goal. Anyway, I'm gonna actually go and do this level now, Donut Secret House. Whatever. You can fly through that slope. I already explained how you can kind of go through slopes while you're flying, but it's not easy to do, so I'm not gonna try to bother to do that. Okay, so you can kill things with your cape. Oh my god. Yeah, that's not what I meant to do. Okay, so there's some sprites in this game that normally can only be killed by like certain things. Sliding, for example, is one way you can kill stuff. So if I lure this Boo over here, please, come here. Where is he? Where'd he go? He's gone. I killed him. I despawned him. Alright. Whoops. Oh my god. Well, what I was gonna show... Here, come over here. You can kill this guy by sliding, basically, is what I'm trying to show. There we go. Killed him. You can kill him by sliding on a slope, like these stairs. Or, if you have a feather, you can actually do a belly slide. By like jumping and then sliding across the ground when you're kind of like parallel to the ground. And a belly slide does the exact same thing as normal sliding on a slope, so it kills the enemies the same way. And so you can actually kill some enemies that normally can't be killed by sliding into them. And if there aren't any slopes nearby, then you can just do a belly slide instead. So, for example, like, in some castle levels, there's actually some sprites, like the, like, circular saws and stuff, that can be killed by sliding, by doing, like, a belly slide, and you can't normally notice that, but, with cape sliding, you can. I'm gonna get the, I guess, secret exit here. I was trying to decide while I was talking, and I was having a hard time multitasking. Okay, so, this boss is pretty easy. The boss itself actually can't hurt you, it's just the booze, his little friends. And falling in the pit is also something you don't want to do. Falling in the, like, area beneath the throw blocks, obviously. Oh yeah, if you're standing on, like, in between two throw blocks and you press the grab button, you'll actually, like, step on the other one so you can grab it, even on level ground like that. And you can also grab... Oops, well... I was gonna show that you can grab a throw block at the exact same time. Trying to... Boom. No. If you do it on the right frame, it looks kinda funny. No. Well, whatever. You can grab a throw block on the last frame before it transitions. It looks kinda silly. Also, you can actually grab a throw block at the same time you jump. So you don't really need to be standing in between two throw blocks to be safe. Like I showed, but it's, yeah. I kind of wanted to finish both ghost houses, but whatever, it's not a big deal. I'm just gonna end it here. I'm at least glad I got to show something off in the top secret area, because that was kind of fun to do. So anyway, thanks for watching, bye.